haciendo para todos los bailadores con esta rola que dice...
What's up, FHS? It's your boy Roman here, and we are having a discussion panel on Hispanic Heritage Month. So we're going to let everybody introduce themselves to their race, their grade, and their name. So, Ari, we're starting with you.
I'm Ari. I'm in ninth grade, and I'm African-American.
I'm Anna Kay. I'm in the 10th grade. I'm a mix between Caucasian and African-American.
I'm Reska. I'm in 10th grade, and I am Caucasian.
Hi, I'm Valerie. I am a senior, and I'm from Honduras.
Hey y'all, I'm Aubrey, I'm in 11th grade, and I'm Pakistani-American.
Hey y'all, I'm Roman, I'm in 11th grade, and I'm African-American.
Hey y'all, I'm Logan, I'm in the 9th grade, and I'm African-American.
Hey, I'm Ray, I'm in 9th grade, and I'm Venezuelan-American.
I'm Ulysses, I'm a senior, and I am Hispanic.
I'm Zozo, I'm a junior, and I'm in 11th grade. Oh, I'm Hispanic. I'm sorry.
I'm a junior and I'm Hispanic.
All right, y'all. So we have a couple questions lined up for you guys. So the first question is, how was it growing up in a different country? And I know everybody hasn't lived in a different country, but somebody that has is Valerie. We had a conversation last year about it in a different video. So how was it like growing up?
Okay, well, I was born in Honduras and I lived there for the first 7 years of my life. While I was there, my parents were able to put me in a bilingual academy. So coming here, I was already really prepared for it. You know, I understood English, and so I didn't really have to struggle with that too much. It was really nice. My family was able to have their own business there, so I was able to experience a good life in Honduras. But coming here, it was definitely a lot different and a completely different lifestyle.
So are you saying your parents, since they put you in a bilingual academy, they already knew that they were coming here?
No, they did not.
So they just wanted you to, they wanted you to speak two languages? Mm-hmm. All right, does anybody else have any questions about her?
Yeah, what is life like living in Honduras?
Well, you know, I lived there for the first 7 years of my life. So while I was there, it really wasn't, you know, the neighborhoods are a lot different. You can't just have, you know, like you can't just walk around like you would in all the neighborhoods we do here. Everything is gated. It's a little dangerous living in the city, but it also comes with its advantages of being able to go places faster, being like there in the center of it all. So it, you know, it was a whole different lifestyle there, and now it's a lot different than it was whenever I lived there. But while I lived there, I thankfully didn't have to experience the like bad side of it, so I'm not too sure about that part.
All right, so you did talk about like the neighborhood experience and how like dangerous it was. So how was just going to the second question, how was it like with school and life, like, well, not life, but how was it like with school,
like over there,
or mm-hmm. different?
And difference, yeah, the difference here. Between from here and school over there.
Well, here, for example, over there we had to wear uniforms, and it was super like, I don't know, like enclosed, mm-hmm. to make sure that, you know, we were all safe and stuff. But here it's a lot more open, like, you know, kids are able to go out a lot more. We have a lot of field trips here. In Honduras we never once had a field trip. It was really nice though. They were always really active with everyone, and I feel like sometimes we do the exact same stuff we do here over there. It was a really nice experience overall, but the school, the teaching, everything was just completely different once I came here.
Okay, so going into the third question, since everybody said they're like different ethnicities, we're a pretty diverse group, what are some traditions that you celebrate in your family, or like maybe some foods that that usually other cultures don't have? And we can just go down the line if y'all want to. Anybody want to speak up? All right,
so. Christmas. We do Christmas differently. We have something called posadas, mm-hmm. which means you walk with the Virgin around on the streets and stuff. That's what we used to do in Mexico. You sing songs, you go knocking on doors, and at the end of the night, there's a house that they choose for the Virgin to stay at, and they just celebrate the Virgin and just celebrate it, and it just repeats night after night.
How many days?
It's all Christmas, technically. Not all Christmas, I mean all December.
Okay. Like, till,
so,
like,
till the day of Christmas, yeah, or the 30th?
Till the 30th.
Okay. Anybody else?
That's cool.
I got something. All right, so on Christmas, it's going to sound gross, but they make something called baniamon, which is like get a lot of bread dough, roll it up, put ham, like olives, raisins, and then just put it in the oven for a little bit, and it's nice and crunchy. And do we make that every Thanksgiving or Christmas? Oh,
raisins.
Delicious.
You said raisins.
Yeah, like, but you won't be able to taste the raisins.
Is it like savory or sweet or what? Is it good? Like,
it's good. I mean, it's like a little bit of everything, kind of.
Y'all
want to
know what I do?
Bread,
basically. Y'all want to know what I do for Chris? I wake up at like this. at like 3 in the morning, I'm gonna be asleep. I wake up and like my gifts, and she'll say no. And the gifts don't be down, they don't be under the tree until like 12 o'clock in the day.
12 o'clock?
Girl. Yeah, and I'll be waiting like all morning for my
midday Christmas.
Huh?
Midday Christmas?
Yeah, he's like, he'll be wanting like in like the morning because she's gonna be
so
bothering her to
Santa. Doesn't come see you.
And yeah, he doesn't come to
the we still say Santa? Okay. Anyway, so one thing y'all didn't mention and I know about is the Day of the Dead. So can y'all elaborate or like what is the Day of the Dead?
Day of the Dead is, it's called Día de los Muertos, where you come together as a family and we say celebrate, remember your loved ones that have passed. You put up a memory of them. You put pictures of all of them and you put food that they liked or food that they ate while they were still with us. And you just sit and just talk with your family and what you remember about them and how they were when they were still with us.
I do have a question. We often have funerals, just as an American kind of culture. Why do you celebrate them every year instead of just having a funeral for them and, you know, remembering them? But do you know why that's such a big thing in Hispanic culture?
So that you won't lose their memory, you would always have them with them. And like that, you just remember them, you know, have good times. And you're just trying to offer them food and stuff, like, keep them in memory.
So it's like a celebration of life every year.
It's like if we were celebrating their birthdays, but instead.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I don't know if any of y'all have seen the movie Coco.
Yeah.
That's
what it basically is.
That's my favorite movie right now, Gail. Anyway.
Wait, what day is it, though?
It's on. I don't remember.
I honestly can't even tell you, to be honest.
I think it's on October 30th, and you keep it. 29th, I think. And you
it's close
it
to Halloween, 31st. Ain't it?
No, it's like 2 days or 1 day off before it.
Close.
Something like that.
Okay. So the next question, we was just talking about schools and how it was like in Honduras. So does Fultondale High School make you guys feel comfortable in your like race?
Yes.
Did they make you feel included?
Yeah, very diverse.
Very diverse. Yeah. Okay. How do they make you feel included?
Everybody is kind to everybody, like no matter who they are. Like, you could go up to somebody and be like, what's up? And they'd be like, what's up? Like, I don't know.
We're all there for each other. Nobody's against anybody.
Yeah.
It's just, like, a school where everybody knows everyone. I mean, everyone's cool with each other.
We all treat each other like the same race.
It just gives us options to, like, accept everybody and where they're from, how they look, everything else.
Because everyone's different here.
Yeah.
All right, so that leads to the next question, because y'all kind of just elaborate on this question, but what do y'all think about the diversity of Fultondale?
Oh, it's very diverse, and I feel like that's a good thing because, like, not everybody, it's not just, like, one culture, one school. It's not boring.
Yeah.
It's not.
And me personally, like, when you get out into the world, you're just not going to be around a certain group of people. So,
right. Yeah.
You
kind of,
and it's kind of like how you learn how to interact with certain people. So,
when we get to college, like, it's going to be people from, like, across the country coming to college. So,
yeah. Or out of the country.
You get a version of every culture here.
You said what?
You do get a version of every culture here.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. So, the next question is. Okay. Next question is, what do you guys like about other people's culture and what do you guys admire about it? So any of y'all can speak in about somebody else's culture.
Well, I love the Mexican culture. I'm not Mexican, I'm from Honduras. But Mexicans,
we're neighbors.
They go all out, like parties. Best parties out there.
Oh.
Like, you can't compare the parties to any other party. Like, we get lit. They food too.
We don't get lit.
It'd be 3 a.m. and we still partying like it's 9 o'clock.
It'd be 4 a.m. we see my drunk tios out there in the car.
So we don't get lit. We don't gotta
not good food.
Oh, I mean, we're not saying y'all don't get no, lit, but like,
not as.
Yeah, not, I don't think. I don't think.
Kind of lit.
Yeah.
I remember going.
It be. Back it could be. You know. I remember my mom's wedding. I didn't get home till like 8 o'clock in the morning. The next morning. You see, it started like 3 o'clock the day before.
That's what y'all say. Yeah. No.
So I didn't get home until like 8 o'clock the next morning.
The thing is that our Hispanic parents expect us to, you know, get home early nowadays that we're kind of grown and we go out to parties, but yet they had us at parties. It would be like,
Diana, you are in 11th grade.
I know, I said kind of.
My mom is so strict on me. Let's be nice about a party.
Well, they'll be like,
okay, yeah.
Like 4 in the morning, we'll be like laying down in a chair sleeping, and now they expect us to get home like at what, 1?
They, yeah, some of us have to be home. If we go out at a party, you go out at 6, 7 o'clock. They want you home by 12.
Shut up.
But yet they have you, but yet they already, like,
7 o'clock
late. But wait, like, what time does the party get started for real? Like,
usually
6-ish is when people start getting there.
So y'all celebrations, like, if y'all go to, like, a quince or, like, a party.
But that's different. A quince, parents normally get there on 4 o'clock because they all eat.
Right.
Us. We get there at 6.
So they say,
because that's when the party's going to start.
If they say get here at 5,
well, said,
they'll end up
getting there at
6.
That's when it really gets lit.
Yeah.
So y'all just like us.
Yes.
We never
go.
But our party started
at 8
o'clock in the morning,
and
then
12
o'clock,
we
take a little break, and then come back to somebody else's house.
Yeah.
That's what we do too.
No. See, so our parties, well, I really can't. Yes, our parties, they last for days. Like weddings and stuff, it's not one day. It's like 3 days. So, like, the first day you eat, and, like, they don't get married on the first day. They have like, this big old couch, and they sit, and people bring them gifts and stuff. And the second day is only for the adults, because, you know, they turn up.
So, and you're Middle Eastern, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so, like, y'all have, like, a three-day celebration of, like, people's marriages?
Uh-huh.
That's a little excessive.
And on the third day, then all the kids come, and then it's just, like, it's all right.
So,
but,
what day do they get married?
What day did they get married?
The third day.
The third day.
Okay.
When everybody comes. And it's big, too. Like, on the third day, you're up, like, all day.
What is the attire like?
Oh, the attire? It depends on where you're at. See, like, I went to this wedding in Texas, like, a few years ago. And, like, you had henna. Mm-hmm. And you had saris. You had the whole get up.
Did you have that on?
Oh, yes. I'm about to turn up. I did. I had everything on. I don't got a picture, but if I did, I'd show y'all. Let me find it, and we're going to put it in the video.
All right, so we kind of already asked this, I'm not going to lie, but we're still going to try to do it. All right, so how is the school system environment different from where you're from and, like, where you are now?
I lived in Mexico for, like, what, 2 to 3 years?
Mm-hmm.
And it's way different over there. I'm not saying teachers don't care, but if you get in a fight, they're not going to separate you. They're technically not going to care, right?
Nope. They're not.
They're not.
Wait. You get in a fight. You just.
They're just gonna stand there and watch y'all. They're not gonna do anything about it. And here, I got here and I got into a fight and I didn't know it was different because no one told me. I got suspended and I'm telling you, it's different. It's just here, teachers.
Y'all
better
not fight about it with standards.
How old were you when you lived in Mexico?
I was. I left at the age of 3 and came back like at the age of 7.
So you came here at 7?
Yeah, I got here in second grade.
You was fine at 7.
Who you got
playing
with?
Because
I don't
remember that. All right,
girl.
All right. Y'all definitely taking that out.
You had another question.
No, I'm going to definitely say this. School here is a lot different than Mexico. Like Valerie said, you do got to wear uniforms. Mm-hmm. And school in Mexico is actually separated by years. Not like here that you go 7 through 12.
Mm.
It's 3 different schools.
What?
And the schools, they're boarded up by concrete walls. And you got busted bottles on top of the wall so that you don't have children climbing over the walls.
Oh. Wait, so what do you mean, like, separated?
Okay.
They'll have a school simply for preschool like that. Like, right here, middle school, high school, and like that.
That's what I was like. Okay, so it's similar, right?
Yeah. I also have another question, though.
Uh-huh.
Like, I know some of y'all are from Honduras. Did y'all have to march every Monday? Because we used to march Mondays and celebrate, like, for the flag, bring out the flags and stuff. Did y'all do that?
At my school, we had, like, I guess you could say, like, chapel. And in the mornings, we would all go there and we'd have, like, worship. It was really big, you know, because it was the whole school. The way that my school was we had all of the grades all in one big, like, I don't know, like, land, I guess.
Campus.
Yeah. And the thing, though, is that there were different buildings for different grades. And so, like, each floor was, like, a different grade and stuff, and we'd all go to chapel. And that's where we'd, like, say the pledge, we'd worship, and then we'd, like, go back to our classes and stuff. But that's how our school was.
So is it more strict, or is America more strict on the school system?
I think America is definitely a lot more strict.
But he just said you got bottom caps on things that want
to
climb over.
That's to protect from, because, you know, the environment isn't safe. Like, on the outside, it's not safe. And so they do that to prevent not only kids from leaving, but from people coming in.
Okay.
I do have a question. So are the schools more spaced out there? Because, you know, we have Gardendale and Fultondale and Mornell Jordan right next to each other.
They're way more spaced out. Mm-hmm. Like, one can be, like, another side of your house, and the other one's, like, another side is just differently.
He said no.
Well,
it depends where you're from.
Oh, yeah. Where, like, I was from, it was way separated.
All right, y'all. So, we got, like, two more questions for y'all. So, y'all was talking about parties and, like, how y'all parents be having y'all home at a certain time. So, what's some unique rules or, like, specific to y'all culture that your parents implement in y'all
studies.
Lives?
If you aren't home by the time they tell you, they'll lock the doors.
Oh.
Supposedly. That's what they say. But, they also be like, I can't sleep till you get home. But don't be sleepy. That's how their rule works. If you don't be home by the time, they'll lock the door.
I've learned that a Mexican household is not a hotel.
Okay.
You don't come and go whenever you want. And one thing is, you got to earn your trust. If you want to go out, you got to earn your trust and show them that you ain't going to go out and just not show up.
You don't just ask for permission, you earn your right to go out.
So if you want to go out on the weekend, you got to start doing chores on Monday.
Or like a month before.
Most of my parents, like, they were born, like, they lived in that different country, you know, they weren't raised here. So coming here, it's like a whole different lifestyle. They're still stuck on the fact, like, whenever, how life was in their country. And living in America, it's just completely different. So, you know, a lot of times they base those rules on the strictness that they would have in, like, for example, Honduras. And, you know, like, I live in a split house. Like, my dad, he's American, but my mom is Honduran. So I get to have, like, both experiences, you know, like, I still have, like, the strictness that comes from, like, a Hispanic household, but I also get to have the freedom that comes from being an American child, because my dad, like, he was born and raised here, you know, so he, like, he knows how life is going to be for us, so it's, like, always a mixture, you know, it's always, like, having to, like, learn from what lifestyle now is.
So your mom is more strict because, like, she grew up in Honduras, so Honduras is more, like, dangerous?
Yeah, so, you know, she was faced with more of those dangers. Like, she was able to, you know, like, she had to see that and live through that. So whenever it comes to parenting me, like, she doesn't want me to experience the exact same things. So she'll force, or she'll look at the rules that way, you know?
All right. So, speaking of parents, y'all know we are all in high school. So we got to start, you know, picking up our weight around the house. That means we're going to have to get a job.
Ooh.
So, how is working in America versus working in Honduras? Some of y'all was like kids, but did y'all parents work in different?
No, both my parents, they owned their own business.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, they started me young, like, learning about all that so that I could grow up and probably, you know, like, lead on the business. But whenever we moved here, we passed it down to my family. So coming here and being able to get my first job, they've always pushed me to work hard, because, you know, they've been working in Honduras. You have to start working a lot younger than people do here. Like, here it's like, oh, I'm 16, I'm able to work now. But over there it's like, you're 12, you're 11, like, you must work to support your family.
And is there, and, like, a, like, you know how we're 16, we can only work like a certain amount of hours. When you're 12, can you work a certain amount of hours, or you can work however long?
No, I think over there you have to work, like, if you were a whole grown adult. It's completely different. There's no child labor laws over there. You know, over there it's like you start working and you get treated the exact same as everyone else.
So what, did I go to school?
It's just depends where you
depends. Yeah, because, you know, like, I never had to work. But I know, like, family, and I know friends of family that did have to do that, you know? So it's just really depending on where you lived, what part you lived, and how it really was around there.
So
it's like where I live, they had to work in the field and stuff, and you had to start working at the age of technically 5-6. My dad was working at the age of 5, literally helping him, my grandpa, you know, moving stuff, working and stuff. It just depends where you're from, and like she said, there's no
so it's like there's labor no laws. Limit at
no,
all.
Literally you'll be working at the age, like my mom was a housewife, technically that's what wives do in Mexico, technically they're just there to help the man. That's what I was doing at that age. I was just helping my grandma and my mom. And yeah, my uncle was what, like 2 years older than me, and he was working with my grandparents and my dad too.
Alright, so age can you
consider an adult?
As soon as you can start walking, you can start working. That's what they say. As soon as you can start walking, you start working.
So like America has all these rules of 21 to drink, 16 to drive.
Yep. And like over there, over there you can learn how to drive whenever you want. Technically, like there's kids that are like 11, 12, and driving themselves exactly.
And nothing is automatic, and all cars are stick shift. So at the age of 5, you're already learning how to drive stick shift cars.
So how did your like parents and y'all's parents? Because I know my dad, he came over here when he was 16. So how, like, what was the story like?
My parents came here. My dad was, I think, 18, and my mom was like 15, 16 when they came here. I think it took them like 2 months to cross the border at first, and after that, the same thing. They went back to Mexico, you know, with me. And the same thing. They left me there simply to come here first because they were like, if we don't make it, at least we don't have to pay another plane ticket for her to come back, you know? Right. And it took them another month or 2 months and a half. And it's the same thing. Harder for them.
All right, so you said your mom and your grandma are like housewives. Like they help around. What's some of the chores that y'all were doing?
Not chores, work. Cooking, and we were gonna cook an animal, trying to kill it first off, trying to catch it. We had to walk up the forest to get water because we had this thing that was like a fountain, supposedly.
It's a whale.
Yeah, kind of. And we had to walk up there to get water. We had to go cut woods and stuff. It was hard to start a fire simply because sometimes there was wind and it would blow out. We had to sweep. We had to just clean the whole house, like technically what you do here, but a little bit more work, because it was mostly all made out of mud too. Houses there are made out of mud, so
lots of household chores.
When you say just you killed chores. The animal, I know a part of African American culture is chitlins, pig intestines.
Yeah,
do you eat like head cheese and pig intestines?
Yes, we would eat chicken. We would cut pigs out. We would eat their like all their insides. Same with
cows.
Tacos.
What about them?
You can eat any type of tacos. Head, tongue.
What is that? Chorizos, they're like their guts.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, this is a little
bit. So when much. I ate some chorizo tacos, that's what it was?
Yes.
Girl. I mean, if it was good, it's good. I can't complain.
Okay, so anyways, y'all. Do y'all have any more questions? Y'all have anything y'all
want to
talk about?
Rummen.
No, you don't,
know,
Aubrey.
Yes, we do.
We don't want to hear about you eating pigs.
No,
because
we're
not talking
about that. Okay.
How was it different for you, though? Like, how was it different for Aubrey? Like,
what do you mean how it was different for me?
Like, what did your parents
okay. Go? Thank you, girl, for asking, because I was about to tell it. So, I was born here, but when my dad was 16, he lived in Pakistan, and so my oldest uncle, him and my father came over here when my dad was 16, but then they had to go back because my uncle could be here, but my dad couldn't. So it took them like a year or almost a year for my dad to be able to get his like visa and stuff like that so he could come over here. So when I think it was, my dad was 18 and he came, 17 when he came. And so he was able to go to high school and he ended up going to college. So then I think it was maybe, it was like 8 years ago, my dad, he worked really hard and he got his citizenship. And so we went to Atlanta and he ended up getting his citizenship. But I have two uncles that currently still live in Pakistan and all my aunts and all my cousins. And it's really spread out like Dubai, Pakistan, India, London, you know, it's very spread out. But
London.
Yeah.
Well, you guys, that is the end of this panel discussion. Does anybody have any more questions? No? Okay, well, it was really fun talking and learning about everybody's culture. And yeah, some of our cultures were similar in different ways. So
I feel like that's like their culture and our culture is like very similar to each other. Mm-hmm. Like almost identical.
Especially with
not
the parenting
identical.
Thing.
Cause, yeah, because yeah. they. hold on. I got to do it.
You can't even do it.
Flip it, girl.
She's not a parent. She don't understand. She don't understand.
Hold on. Anyway. I get it. Hold on. I got to eat it. I'm going to eat it off.
Logan, you done. Logan, you done. Anyway, guys, it was really fun. And until next time.
All right. Bye, guys.
I hit myself with the crawl.